So now that we got our attention is all in there, I'm putting in new sprockets here. You can see we've got some circles and some ovals. Now this is on the rear cylinder bank, okay, the passenger side. What you're going to do is we're going to line up these two blue links like so. One hand is not easy. Okay, and now we have in this chain, as you can see, the light. We got one blue. Well, this one blue is my 12 o'clock, where my paint mark is in relation to the cover. Anyway, you flip this over from the back where it goes on that back sprocket. Well, you've got a dimple, I'm sorry, a circle and an oval. Well, it goes to that circle, circle to circle. And then we're going to slide her back on. It's really hard to do one-handed, but as you can see, we got our two, not focusing, on the blue. And then we can turn this over. Slippery gloves, deal with it. There's a dimple there. I don't know if you can see the blue in that light. And she mocks up there. So that blue one matches up to the back side of that. Okay? And that's how she's going to go, just like that. All right, something funny. Getting that back on. She turned on me. She went back counterclockwise. So we're just going to stick this cam back on with my mark that I have here, which I mocked up to that at 12 o'clock. And we'll get her set again, and we'll do this again. So put the cam back on, put the bolt in it now. You can see my white line there. We got to get that back to there. I'm going to line her back up right where she was. I'm going to use my 90 the same way I put her in. I put it in that groove and I ran the line. And she lines up, so we're good. Try it again. So that's a good thing. You definitely make your marks, and because they're being keyed, really helps too. So she's back aligned. Put the impact on it while I held it and just give it a quick zap, took the bolt back out because it wasn't very tight for me hand turning it. I'm going to do this again. Alright, she's on. Be really gentle so that you don't friggin' hit that damn thing. The compression stroke. You see how my marks line up. That mark lines up. And then we got two blue links right there on the two rounds. Okay. Your other blue link right there is on that dimple back there, which aligns to the one on the back of it as well. So as long as all those are lined up good, see it? Dead center. You put these back on your gears and put the bolts back in. And that's one. And you guys are putting your bolts back in, just finger tight, okay? I might a little too tight. This way you're not going to tighten anything down until we have the second one in and then our primary. And then tensioners put in place. This one still has the pin in it. Back there, see that pin? And we're going to do the other one, and we're going to put our top back on and take pressure, or add pressure, I should say, and then we're going to tighten these down and torque them. So for right now, finger tight, done. Okay, for the driver's side now, we got to do the one, you got two here, same thing, two and then one colored. So the one colored is going to go on the back of this, and there's my 12 o'clock. And you can see, I can flip this. On the ovals on this one. The other side was circles, this side's oval. See the oval there? And you got a dimple right there, which is my blue on the oval, okay? And then these two right here colored are going to go, there's your round and there's your oval. These two are going to go on the oval for this side, okay? And then we're going to put that back on. And hopefully we don't have our cam move on us again. Okay, this is a little easier now that I know to be gentle. It was a little easier. So just to make sure You see our blue line? Right there, right on our dimple. Bam, centered. And then we got our two right here, centered on the ovals as well. I had to just lift up on the time. I had a problem with the timing gods. Tensioner, sorry. I just had to push down and get the chain around it with a screwdriver, but nice and gentle, right in. So same thing, we're just going to put the bolts in. Finger tight. Get these guys going. And then we'll do the main chain. Yeah, so one quick thing here. Noticing we got a lot of play in this chain, right? The tension is depressed. Well, this one's fucking tight. Not moving. Well, I just looked. And, let me see or not, but we wasn't aligned correctly on this guide. I got part of it on the rim of the guide. So I'm using this pick here and just pulling it through, being really gentle not to move this again because I don't feel like realigning it. So make sure you have the same amount of play before you move on to the, you know, next step. Okay, now that she's free, you can see the chain's in there now and she's moving. All in, so we're good. Couldn't figure out the problem on the tightness over here, so I pulled the cans back off. I'm checking the tensioner here, and the factory one, you know, it's got a slit in the back of it. You can see it right here. Okay, that looks factory, but over here, it looks like a little notch out or something. I don't know what that is. But either way, the new ones, since I'm not doing the big job, this one doesn't. It's a little different, so, but the springs are the same. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the new spring and the new guide, whatever, and I'm just going to slap that into the old piston because I don't feel like doing that big of a job, and see if that's going to fix my problem right here for the being too tight on this side when it's still compressed and locked. Also, if you can see here, Stanley will focus. We obviously have some wear on this one. You can see the wear, and the other guides did not, so I'm going to replace, like I said. Okay, I'm just finishing the cleaning on this bottom gully, and all I'm doing is really gentle with this metal pick, just kind of loosening up the chunks without trying to score it too much. And then I'm going back with some toothpicks, and these guys are working pretty good. Get them in there and you can kind of dig now and get the big chunks out. Make sure nothing's falling in your oil pan. And that's pretty much it, all I'm doing. This way I don't have to worry about scoring this. This is pretty soft and it's working very well. Alright, so what I did, I took our main chain and the blue link. There we go. Blue link is on our 12 right there. This blue link, same thing, right on there. And then this one I just slid over the guide. Okay, it's compressed, main tensioner, slide over this, and now I'm down here. Now this bottom one, you can see our other blue link right there. Well, that goes to this mark here, okay? So let me show you that. You see that little indent? There you go, down there, where that middle finger is. That's where you're going to line up your blue mark to, okay? And that's what we're going to do. And this is keyed as well, so obviously it only goes on one way. And then we're going to try and get this through there. Now, if it doesn't, what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull this bottom sprocket off, put it on the chain itself, and then I'm going to slide it in as one piece, which I think I have to do. Okay, so slight problem here. I took out the secondary tensioner, And the other one here, the arm tensioner here, or the pivot bolt, and we're going to try and get it back on. Okay, so make sure your line's marked up. Your blue is your keyhole, there's your line. And we're going to line her up that way. Now make sure you're holding the bottom of this chain, because so much slack, she will move on you. Oops. Chain goes in front of the water pump. On the water pump, I should say. And then, still got tight, but we're almost there. All right, we're good. So, as I said, I took off the tensioners, the one here, the slide, and then the main arm pivot bolt. And what I did is, I ran the arm from the top of the arm on the bottom of the chain. I ran it up, and I compressed the main tensioner a little bit more. I used my own paper clip to hold it in there. And then I just kind of got it over this, where it sits. And then put a screwdriver in very gently and pulled this back that way, okay, to the right. And just got it lined up, threw the bolt in, tight. Now she's pretty tight. Now we're just going to put in our secondary, our back end. And this one's going to go in a lot easier, as you can see. Pretty much no problem. Bolts will line right up. No problem at all. And then she's on. Okay, pivot bolt tensioner. Lock back in. Torque down. Secondary tensioner slide. Lock down. Check our marks. One last time. We're good. We're good on the front. That one on the back. Primary chain, good. That one. Good. These guys, good. That one, good. And then I'm just gonna pull the pin out of the main tensioner and make sure she don't jump. So I'm gonna put a little pressure on here with my finger off camera. And pull the pin and let her come back nice and slow so she don't jump. But definitely after you do this, just check your marks one more time with your chains. Okay, so now I'm just putting on our primary top chain guide. And this is going to get torqued down to 72 inch pounds. And these are 10s. Click, click, click. And that's that. Okay, so now that that's on, we're going to tighten up your cam gears here. And before I do that, everything's pulled, all my tensioners, guides are good. Everything's torqued down that's on here already, minus these guys we're going to do now. I'm going to put on my harmonic balance, a crank pulley. If this thing ever focuses, that'd be nice. Okay. So in case anything does move, it's going to move together, crank and all. So it's not a big deal. I can fix from there. Anyway, here's my original one. You can see the gasket's all blown. Probably giving me vibration and shaking of the motor, which I didn't notice, but we're taking this off, you can see. So, and I got a new one from a local guy in South Florida here. $50 is a lot better than going to the junkyard on a bike and ripping it off. So it looks pretty much good. There's your two lines. And my right black one unpainted. But if you line this up to the keyway, you're going to see on mine. I don't know if you see that on the camera or not. She lined up there. She is slightly off if you see that. I'm lining up this one to the keyway. She's right on that white line. So she moved a little bit, that's for sure. Okay, so I tightened that up with impact and put my breaker bar in it, and right now, I just did this side, 76, 76, this guy's 91, and this guy's 91, and that is what I am doing at the moment. And surprisingly, the breaker bar is working where I don't have to tie down my crank pulley again like I did when I took it off, wiring it up with the belt and the chain wrench and stuff. So I got a whole lot of room in here and I don't want to use an extension, but we're going to try it. There we go. 3R tight. I'm gonna try. Okay, so as I'm doing now that those guys are tightened up, I'm just doing more by hand just to feel anything to make sure. So every two revolutions on your crank pulley is one revolution on your cams, okay? And that's all I'm doing. Just making sure that everything's really good. I'm probably at like 12 times, 15 times on the revolutions on the crank. So, you know, times two of that is your cams. And gives plenty of time for everything to open. Valves, piston, whatever. Nothing's hitting, especially if piston's hitting your valves, because that's going to be a little stopping point right there. And your timing's way off. And now I think this, between the other VQ35 motor, where this is the 40, these have the longer stroke too, which kind of scares me. I think the Ultimas have the 35s or whatever, the other Nissans. And that's really it, so. And I got my number one spark plug, obviously, out, but I took off the coil to help it breathe. And, you know, my intake is taped up, so you can hear that kind of hissing from the tape. Okay, she's all good to go. We're just going to take our, that came off pretty easy. Take off our crank pulley and button it up. And that's it. And there's that key right where she's supposed to be anyway. I stopped her. Okay, since I'm into this job and I had a little oil leak coming from my oil cooler, we take out our oil filter, which right here, okay. Unscrew your oil filter, and then you're going to take this out. This is a 22 millimeter nut on there, which I didn't have, so 7/8 worked. You pull out your bolt, and this comes apart. And then what you're looking at is the inside. You can see my gasket right there. And that gasket was leaking on the bottom. I had some drips, which is convenient on the tray, and came down. So we're just going to replace the gasket. I got a factory one. Okay, right from Nissan. So we're going to clean this up, obviously. Put that back in there. You can see the rim around it, the clean spot where the gasket goes. Clean this up good. Put the bolt back in. Okay. And then we're going to tighten this nut down to, I think it's 36 foot-pounds or 49 newton meters for torque. And put our new oil filter on, and we're done with this job. So it's probably going to take me longer to clean up that gunk than it is to do this whole change of seal. So there she is, all nice and cleaned out. I'm going to sap up that oil a little bit, and we're going to put the new gasket right in there on the outside of the two holes. And we're bolt her back in. Like I said, 36 foot-pounds or 49 newton meters. And put our oil filter back on, and that job's done. Do a little cleanup here. Some dirty oil, I guess, for people not changing their oil, but you clean it up really good. And brake cleaner, let it soak. And toothbrush works really well. Look at that, brand new. Okay, since we got this cover out, I'm gonna wipe it down one last time with some brake cleaner. And then we're going to get her sealed up, but we're going to have to replace this crank seal real fast. So, here's a new one here. Here's the number.
and just since it's out, instead of putting, you can use a screw on the other side, obviously, or the outer side, and gently get it in there, like a drywall screw or something. Then you can pull these out while they're still attached. But for here, I'm going to try and just very carefully not to hit the lip. I'm going to put this in and just push it out or bang it out. And we're going to lube this up with some oil and put it in. And if I have a problem seating it, since I have my cams, I'm going to try and use that and see if that'll be flush, since I don't have a big enough socket to put on this and push her in from the other side, obviously. Now you'll notice too, the groove, you see it, there's the metal in there. But that goes on the inside towards the engine block, okay? Just like that. You can see this side is flat. So that's going to be to the outer, to the crank pulley, and the opening is going to go towards the engine itself. Just like that. Okay, so getting this crank seal out wasn't that bad, but it was a little tricky. I didn't have a sock enough big enough, so we tried a 32. I had a piece of rubber I got in there. It didn't. So what I did is I broke pieces of the off, and that metal lip right there, if you guys can see that, there's a little metal lip in here. And right on that metal tab, I just put a screwdriver, nice and flush, gently, make sure it was straight. And I tapped her and she popped right out. So we're going to put some oil on the new one, clean this up a little bit. Put a little bit of oil on this and we're going to pop it in. She looks good there. And she's nice and flush out here. Okay, we're going to replace these seals right here. And then that one, these two. Now these guys are here, right from Nissan, again. And what they do is, these shoot oil into the front cover, which is your covers, and it goes in through the cover and goes back into your actual cam sprockets. So it's an oil passage that comes in from here, shoots over into your cover, it comes down, if you look at the cover, and goes back into oil your cams up. And we're going to replace these. We're just going to pull them out with a pick, make sure they're nice and clean, and then we're going to put a little oil on these guys, just like we did the crank seal, and we're going to put that on these things, lube them up, and we just firmly press them back in there and make sure they're flush. Okay, so my cover's through on my first one. Like I said, all I had to do is I bended this one a little bit flat to get through the passageway. We're all cleaned up. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to run a bead down here on the oil pan, okay, all the way around, and then we're going to put a bead on the actual cover, and we're going to start putting our bolts in. Now, this is the tightening sequence, and we took this off in the reverse order. But keep in mind, 1 through 5, I believe, are your bigger bolts, and number 5 right here, if you look, is smaller than the other ones, okay? This guy right here is shorter on the bigger bolts. Now, on the rest of them, you have 24 and 25 on your 10s are actually a little bit longer, okay? These two and the one next to it, they're longer than the rest of them. So keep that in mind, 24 and 25 are long on your 10s, and number 5 is short on your bigger bolts, okay? Okay, she's in seated, and everything is hand tight by the tightening sequence. And we're going to give an hour to the RTV directions, and then we're going to talk her down to specs. Okay, don't forget about your two oil pan bolts that you took out. This is the one, and then your other one's up there. Okay, we put the oil pan bolts in. Now here it says to, if you guys can see this or not, we're going to torque, install the two bolts in the upper pan and torque to 16 foot-pounds, okay? And then, I already did that. Now I'm just finished tightening all the bolts on the cover here. And now, as you can see, your bolts 1 through 5, which are your big bolts, your 14s, they get torqued to 41 foot-pounds. And then from 6 to 25 on your bolts, which are the 10 millimeters, you're going to go to 9 foot-pounds. And that's where we're at. Now, when I did that, I did it 3 times, because when I went back a second time just to make sure I did hit all my bolts, I noticed a couple of them were could go a little bit more from the seal, from the RTV kind of spreading. So I'm going to give this about 10 minutes, And then I'm going to recheck my Torx one more time. Okay, just installed our idler pulley and clutch fan back on. You got 1, 2. Three down here, and then 4 like we took it apart. And these get torqued down to 41 foot-pounds. Okay, putting your power steering bracket on, this front bolt right here. This one's 21 foot-pounds, okay? Your ones in the back, those two right there on the side of your bracket, those guys right there are going to be 12 foot-pounds. All right, so now your top bolt that goes in side there, which has the two small one first and the big one, goes into this, and then the one in the back that's not threaded, and it's going to go just like that, okay? That sits out on top, and that screws in. Then that one right there gets to 35 foot-pounds. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and slide this in there because it was tight getting it out, and then I'm going to put the bolt through and then put this on the back and torque her down. Okay, there's a correction on that little bracket. I went to your power steering. You see it back there? It goes down, okay? At a notch there from where it hits. And that's your stopper. So that's the way it sits, not on top. It does not sit horizontal. Okay? Okay, power steering pump is installed, okay? I had a real bitch of a time getting in that one to the case because it wasn't lining up and you don't want to strip that. It was on an angle. So this sucker is so tight inside this bracket. What I did is I just kind of wiggled back and forth, and then under it, I banged kind of gently with a, kind of is the key word, with a hammer, and got her to come up. And then also I stuck a pry bar in this corner where I pried it out from the bottom in the same thing on the bracket, but you're putting stress on these bolts, the two in the back and the one here, so gentle. I put my pry bar in there, and I kind of just turned back and forth with it while I was lifting, and I got it to line up, and that's how I got her in. So I actually loosened this bolt down here in there just a little bit because there was play in that bolt. This whole power steer needed to come up. So I loosened this up, jiggled it around, got her to line up good, put her in, and then I tightened that one back up. So now we're going to move on to the alternator. Okay, alternator bracket right there is in. Okay. Sits on a little groove there on the pan. And then that hole right there is going to take the long bolt. Okay. Which is going to be this guy here. Now the small bolt is going to go back into the bracket. Okay. And then we're going to hook up our two electricals. Alright. We got our one bolt there in, alternator. Bottom bolt with the bracket. And then that bolt there, bracket to alternator, okay? And those get, the lower bolts get torqued down to 21 foot-pounds. And your upper bolt says 48, which goes into the case, you know, your front cover. And I didn't do that, man. I hit 40 and that sucker was tight. So I left it at that. Now I'm going underneath. We got to put in our two connectors to the actual alternator. And you can see that. There's one. I already got it on with the nut. I just got to tighten it, and then our plug that I had taped off right here, and as you can see, alternator gets plugged right back in there, and the alternator is done. Okay, now I'm under the car again. I did that, and now I just got to put on my looms, which I kind of got on there already. There's one, and there's this guy here. Make sure you're all good, and that's it. Okay, I got most of it all hooked back up, leaving a few things off on the top part here. Because since I'm into this brutal job, I'm going to replace my valve cover gaskets, because they're a little wet down there. And also the cam solenoid adjusters, I think they're called. There's one on each side. And these gaskets are the same. Identical, and your valve covers are obviously different. So we're gonna start, I already numbered my wires and the coil heads, and I'm going to mark some stuff that I have to make sense, and we're going to take off the valve cover. And then from there, the only thing I can see in the way of this guy is probably just a ground. That looks about it. So that's what we're going to do right now. And then we'll work on the bank too on the passenger side after this. Okay, so what I did is I pulled the breather out. There we go. This breather, which I noticed mine's cracked, so we're going to replace that. And that just goes from that valve cover to that valve cover. Okay, just get out of my way. I unplugged my coils. Just pulling on the clips, and they pull right out. A flat spot for these? Yeah, I do. One. And then just lift them right out. Whoa, that's a big problem. Okay, found a problem. Anyway, we pull these out, and then we're going to see what this is. Yeah, it's got a chunk taken out, that's for sure. Somebody's not gentle in here who put them in. That one, I'm surprised, did not leak. But this guy, look at that thing. That thing is all hacked up. That is the problem. Missing chunks. Okay, we went and got some new valve covers. Check these guys out. Okay. Just putting the gaskets in right now. And what I'm going to do is, because when we flip this over, they're going to pop out. These pretty much have a little lip. They don't crunch all the way down. So what I'm going to do to help me with that, I'm going to take a dab of RTV, just a dab, and just kind of put it, you know, in spots. Kind of like just spot welding, and just so she holds in place while I clean up my other stuff and put my plugs in. So let this dry, and that's what I'm going to do right now. Okay, now that we got our gaskets drying, what I'm doing is you have two spots in the front here. Here. Can't see it. And here, where you got to apply some RTV. Okay, so I'm just cleaning them up with the razor right now. Okay, getting this oil out, all I'm doing is twisting some paper towels. I went to Bounty because it's absorbing a little bit better. Quick to pick her up, her boy. Jamming that down in, and I pulled out a ton of oil, and then very gently, now that I'm in the end of it, I'm putting it in, pushing it down gently with my screwdriver around the spark plug, and then I'm putting my air compressor in there, and kind of giving it a little passageway to blow, and a little passageway for the exhaust, obviously, and it blows into the paper towel, and that's all I'm doing, and blowing the excess drops that are left in it. All right, now that she's all cleaned up, she's wiped down brake fluid, we got to put a little RTV, like I said, in that spot there and the one below it, where your cam bracket and the cylinder head meet. Okay, yeah, right in there. And that's where a majority of it was that I scraped off and stuff. Make sure all your bolt holes are clean and everything like that. And I'm going to put my RTV on, and I'm going to throw the new cover on. Okay, I had a problem getting them over these spark plug things. So what I did is, on the wells, I put a little oil on the actual wells themselves, and then on the inside of the gaskets, and psh, she popped right down. Nice and sealed. So we got to do this in stages here to tighten her back down. So what we're going to do is, your number one is the second one. Okay, that's number one. And then you've got two directly across, three in the back before the end, four directly across, five is your front one down here, and then six is here, seven is the back one, eight, the other back one, okay, nine is this one here, and ten is directly back of the cover, okay. Now what we got to do is we got to tighten these in two rounds, okay. The first round is going to be 17 inch pounds. And then the second round, we're going to go back, and you know, 1 to 10, and we're going to stop back at 1 again, and we're going to go back to 74 inch-pounds. I got a new breather hose. Goes from valve cover to valve cover. Okay. This is going to be, there's a part number right there. 11826EA200 is your part number. Okay, moment of truth. Pulled the fuel pump fuse. I want to turn it a little bit. Get the oil running. Okay.
Fuse pump, fuse back in. What we got here? She's running. Well, she sounds nice. No more ticking. Oh shit. Check for leaks. Okay, so here she is. No lights. VDC was because I forgot at 2 o'clock in the morning that my tire was off. So that's it. That little sucker there, that little doodaddy, that's just from damn wheel sense that always known for these cars. So we're good. Holy damn, no lights.